Amanda?
My name is Amanda Ellistad. I'm looking for my dream dress.
Hi.
This is my best friend, Missy.
Hi. So nice to meet you, sweetheart. You ready?
Yes, indeed.
Okay.
Now, I do want to tell you I have a dress.
Once you find a dress, it's kind of like finding a guy. You need to stop looking.
You bought a dress.
I put a deposit on a dress, so I wanted you to know that. Yeah. This other dress, I found it a few weeks ago. So that's the front of it. That's my niece.
Oh, how precious.
She's gonna be my little flower girl. I had to put a 50% deposit on the other dress.
She purchased that dress and kept this appointment.
I'm still interested in looking and just seeing if there's anything out there that might possibly trump that dress.
I think that's just kind of a combination for disaster.
With a deposit down on her first gown, Amanda's budget for another dress is $2,000.
I'm very aware that to purchase a dress on top of the one that I've already got, I would lose my 50% deposit. I've gotten into figure competition, so part of the reason I wanted to come here today was to take that step from being this buff female to the absolute princess that every girl wants to be when she's growing up.
Of course. Well, we'll make sure you're a princess. That I can promise. Briefly, just give me a little bit about the wedding so I get an idea of the atmosphere.
It's going to be here in New York, and we found an Italian restaurant that's really close to Times Square. My fiancé's name is Dustin McVeigh. I was teaching group fitness, and he was a personal trainer. So we worked side by side. When I met him, I was like, this must be what love really feels like.
I'm shopping.
All right.
I'll be back. Most girls that come to Kleinfeld and they purchase the dress already, 90% of the time, they stay with the original dress. If I can find her something drop dead for like two, and if she loves it more than the other dress, I think then she'll be okay with losing the deposit.
Sensing that this bride is setting herself up for wedding day blues, Randy talks to Amanda about her other dress.
Is it on hold, or?
I've left a deposit on it.
Okay, so it's yours?
Yes, it's
mine. And you love it?
I do love it, yeah.
If she found this dress that she loved, she should purchase it and have canceled this appointment. Now where do we go from here?
Always aiming to please, Audrey attempts to outdo Amanda's other gown.
I didn't think that I'd want anything that was too big. I definitely like this upper bust area.
Oh, wow. You're good.
This dress makes me feel like a princess, but it didn't quite feel like me.
You sort of look like a doll right now. It's a beautiful, but I don't know if it's you.
Yeah.
I think that you need to try a different style since you already have a style you like.
Can we throw in the Marissa next?
I'm always optimistic that I'm going to find a dress that she was going to love more than the dress that she already purchased. What?
It's gorgeous.
Really?
Yeah, you're a pain in the butt. This dress has elements that definitely trump my current dress.
Now, this is completely different, and I wanted to show you something that was different from the dress that you already had. How do you feel in it?
I'm worried that I might have found a dress.
Well, you came here. It's not my fault. When I pulled a dress that she liked better, I think it really threw her a curveball.
What is this one?
24.
Uh-oh, that's really doable.
Yeah, and I love this veil.
It sent her reeling into this moment of, what do I do?
Right after seeing this, you'd be happy wearing the other dress.
Oh, that's a good question. I keep staring at this because it's just so beautiful. Okay, here's how I feel.
Talk to me.
I don't want to even look any further. I love this.
The second that we found a dress that was more beautiful than the dress she had chosen, she shut down.
I'm worried I'm gonna have to go home and just weigh the economics of the whole thing. Yeah, I love looking at it.
I think it completely freaked her out. She does not want to know that there's a dress out there that she passed up that's gonna make her look more beautiful than the dress she already purchased.
My gut feeling at the moment is, I don't even know. Doesn't quite sit right. That dress trumps the dress at home. I need to just step away.
So if you're not gonna play by the rules, then you're ultimately gonna lose the game.
Breaking the rules backfired. Amanda leaves empty-handed, and she has to settle on the dress she already has.
My name is Margaret Zachary, and my wedding is in 3 months.
Is that the wedding date?
That is the wedding date, actually. So I have quite a tall order.
Margaret's brought her maid of honor, a bridesmaid, and her little sister to help her find the dream dress.
I'm paying for my dress. The practical side of me is leaning more towards finding a wedding gown within a certain budget.
Margaret, tell me a little bit about your fiancé.
My fiancé's name is John Khalil, and he's currently a lawyer. We've been dating for 12 years. He is the most selfless, generous person that I know. That's why I try to be a little bit more practical, because I know if it was up to him, he'd give me anything that I want. I'd like something that's a true mermaid.
Mm-hmm.
I am a little bit amenable to maybe a ball gown if I absolutely love it.
Okay. Is there any price point that you want it to be in?
I think I'd like to stay under $5,000. I love the Panina Tornée. It's a mermaid. I had seen through the corner of my eye the Panina Tornée dress.
So you like Panina's dresses, huh? Margaret has her eyes on a Panina Tornée dress. It's above budget, probably by about $1,500.
In hopes of beating the more expensive Panina dress, Debbie puts Margaret in a ball gown that's within her budget.
I hate it.
I know. Okay, it's a definite solid no.
Wow.
I'm very glad that I have such a definitive feeling towards it. Overall, it's not what I was looking for.
With the ball gown out of the picture, Margaret puts on a mermaid dress that's under her budget.
I really like the belt.
Do you
like it?
It's beautiful. And this truly is the only dress that I have with this shape, exactly.
I feel simple. I don't think it represents my personality.
She likes it, but she doesn't love it.
Margaret's not loving either dress because she can't get the Panina out of her mind.
Can I just try on the Panina Tornée to see the one that you said was out of my price range, to see if I love it?
You're gonna fall in love with a dress that may be way more than you really have to spend. So you've really wasted an hour and a half.
This is the dress that Margaret is describing. It's $6,500.
You're right, I shouldn't try it on the dress.
I was hoping that I would hate it, and that it would make me feel better about the other dress.
Looking at the cost of this dress, it could also help renovate our bathroom and our kitchen.
Debbie was right. She warned me about the dress.
I do know. I understand the temptation.
But I do. I like it a lot. Hopefully my sisters won't like it.
Oh, no.
What's wrong? I love it, Margaret.
Look.
I love that dress.
Right when I came out and I saw her face, I knew it was immediate trouble.
Oh, my God, Margaret, I love it.
So you all definitely prefer this dress more than the other?
Yes.
How do you feel?
Definitely this dress.
This has more of a wow factor.
It's so wow.
It's very dramatic. It's everything that she could possibly dream of, except for the price point.
No. It's only $1,500 more than what you wanted to spend?
$6,500.
Yeah, you want to spend $5,000.
That could be a small car.
So where do we go from here? I warn her over and over again, but you know what? Margaret is determined.
So the dress is $6,500, and the rush fee is $600. The alterations are $595.
We're looking close to $75,000 to $80,000. It's well over budget.
You would still have to leave 60% of the retail if you ordered today.
I continue to think about it constantly. So I knew that if I couldn't get it out of my mind, then it was probably the best way to go.
Sometimes you have to throw the rules out the window and go with your gut.
She went $3,000 over her budget to get the dress of her dreams. And a month later, Margaret is back for her fitting.
I will probably have to be making a few more concessions in regards to this wedding, but I knew that I had no choice but to get this dress.
Okay. Look, who's here? Fight so hard to stop you from putting this on.
I remember.
You look amazing. Do you love it?
I love it. I love it even more than when I first got it.